Well, hello and welcome to Villaggio del Rugby here in Napoli, the home of the Amatori Rugby Club, for coverage of Rugby Sevens from the 30th Summer Universiade. And this is the most important session of all when it comes to Rugby Sevens. So let's get into it. First up, it's the men's bronze medal match. Both teams very good at defending. Some fast footwork there from Chikbarov. And now it comes back into Golic's hands. Bondarenko. There's a chance. This will be a try. Russia get the first score, and it's the captain, Vitaly Tikhonovic, who goes over and opens the scoring for Russia. Very nice play from the Russians. Finish that move off. France just running out of numbers. It's good play. You can see that player Bondarenko sucking in two defenders. He drew in the outside defender, and that created the space for the captain to open the scoring. There's the conversion attempt. It's just drifting to the right-hand side of the post. So 5 points to nil. It's a good kickoff too, very high. That will be contestable. The very important part of sevens these days is making the ball contestable from kickoffs, and if you can win it, as the Russians have done here, it's a huge advantage. Oh, that's a lovely little stab kick. Tikhonovic is through again. He's going for the corner. And he's got there. No, he hasn't. Let's have a look here. What's the referee going to decide here? He has awarded the try. Wonderful score in the corner. Very clever kick here. Tikhonovic was on it in a flash. Got a really good bounce. And then it was just a foot race. And he had his eye for the try line, no doubt about it. Beautifully finished. And the captain is on the board for two tries. It's a well-struck conversion attempt, but it is going astray. Ivan Mukin, the goal kicker for Russia. So 10 points to nil. Jordan Seffel has created an opportunity here. And that is some serious gas. Great tackle, though. That's the captain, Perrot Tuilonius. It's still alive for France. Big opportunity for them here. Here is Seffel again. He's only 10 metres out. Dubois, big numbers for France here. Puskas, Puskas for the line, and he'll score. Leonard Puskas, 19-year-old from the University of Bordeaux. He's got France right back into this contest now. It's 10 points to 5. Did really well, and Seffel it was who originally created everything on the left-hand side, along with the nippy captain, Perrot Tuilonius. Good strength shown by Puskas here. Get over to score his third try of the tournament. Now, this is an important conversion attempt, and it's gone over. So France narrow the gap to three. Tuilonius is the man who converted the try. Now, the big, fast, and big striding Seffel's away. Oh, check this fellow out. Oh, special. Toying with the defense. How good was that try? And France have the bronze medal here at Napoli 2019 in the Rugby Sevens. Fine comeback from them. They were down 10-0 at halftime. And they win the game with two second-half tries. We now move to the men's gold medal match. Japan and South Africa, not to be underestimated as well. Hamada. Radonsa is making some big tackles for South Africa. Kawasaki in midfield again. Here they come again through Fuji. Fuji. Now is Kuyama. Here's a chance for Fuji again. Fuji, oh, it's a try. Almost a fantastic tackle in the corner. But Fuji, Kentaro Fuji. Has scored the try. Blistering pace from the 19-year-old bronze medalist at the Youth Olympic Games last year for Japan, Fuji. Check out this finish. Desperate defense coming in from Eugene here, but he couldn't quite get there. And that was lovely finish as he slid over from Kentaro Fuji. Now the conversion attempt. Don't think it's got enough gas. It hasn't. So Fuji gets the first score. Wonderful. Hamada. Penalty to Japan. Taken quickly. And away goes Saito. Here's an opportunity. Could be another try. Yes, beautifully finished. Masaki Hamada. So Masaki Hamada stretches Japan's lead to 10 points. Offloads in the tackle beautifully to receive that pass as Hamada. And he rolled over and forced that nicely too. Now this just gives Japan a bit of breathing space if he can nail this conversion. Good looking attempt, but it is astray. And it is 10 points to nil. Still, it is Japan with 2 tries to nil. Here's a gap up the middle maybe for South Africa to exploit. Van der Linde. Really have had no chance at all. Now Arensa chases this one through. He's got outstanding pace. He's got it. What a try. Kurt Lee Arensa. Showing us why he is now a full senior South African rep in Sevens rugby. He's played in the World Series circuit in Hong Kong, Vancouver, Singapore, London, and he just gassed the man on the outside. Brilliant. So that's got South Africa back in the hunt. It's his first try too of the tournament. No luck with the conversion. Excellent defense from South Africa, but they've conceded the penalty, taken quickly by Matsumoto. Here comes Saito. Numbers game here. Oh boy. A try blown there by Suoka, but he's recovered. And he has done brilliantly there. Has he Dito Suoka. Big score there for Japan. And it's looking very good for the men in red and white now. Got plenty of elusive, robust skills there. Has Shitaro Suoka, 23-year-old from Baikyo University in the Itsubashi Ward in Tokyo. That conversion has gone astray. So 15-5, and now it's really against the South Africans. We only have 20 seconds to go. South Africa are out of time. Even if they score a converted try, they won't win the gold medal. They'll continue to try. Arensa, kick and chase. Oh, no bounce, but Arensa's got it back, and he'll score. Lovely infield pass to Oberholzer. Oberholzer's going to go in and score the try. But it won't be enough for South Africa. Conversion from in front, but Japan, it's their day. Oberholzer converts the try. But it is Japan's gold medal One last look at the try here from Arenza, and then the infield pass to Oberholzer. But it's Japan's gold medal. They win the game 15-12. Fantastic all-round effort from this Japanese team. They were a wonderful team to watch. And it is